Hello everyone, welcome to Time Online Classes. Today in this session we will discuss important models for IBPS PO and SBA PO prelims, linear arrangement with some extra variable like ages and they are having some pens like that kind of variable, and the one more model is years based. You will be given a base year, you have to identify the ages of those persons, this kind of. These two puzzles are very, very important for IBPS PO as well as for SBA PO. For both these exams, these models are very, very important. Okay. Again, level of difficulty may vary. In SBA PO, you may get higher level of difficulty. In IBPS PO, you may get lower level of difficulty. Depends upon your slot. Okay. So we have taken moderate level of difficulty questions here. Let's, without wasting the much time, first we'll discuss the linear arrangement and cube year. And here in these questions, we are not going to discuss the basics. Here we are going to discuss what kind of approach has to be followed to complete the puzzle and what kind of analysis you require to solve the puzzle. That approach we are going. Okay. We have given 5 questions below this, and what is the information given? 6 persons A, B, C, X, Y and G are sitting in a row facing north, clearly mentioned, same direction, but not necessarily in the same order. Each person has a different number of pens, but the pens are not mentioned. It means while going through the information, we will get that values. The following information is known about them and we have given some information. So let's copy the information to the next slide and we'll complete it. And here we cannot take the definite structure. Like for circular, we have taken a definite structure. We can take for months based or for square arrangement. For all those things, we can take a definite structure. But whereas when it comes to the linear, you cannot take it until and unless you know the definite position of one of the person. So let's see what is the first clue is given. Let's add the information. Again, start from the first clue. C sits third to the right of the person who has 36 pens. Okay. C sits third right. Third right means how many gaps will be there? 2 gaps will be there to the right side of whom? The person who has 36 pens. And who will be there? C will be there. So let me write it. 36, right side 2 gaps, and who will be there? C will be there. And means we are talking about the first person. Who is that first person? C. C sits third to the right of the person who has 36 pens and sits to the immediate left of 5. So C sits immediate left of 5. C sits immediate left of Y is as good as Y sits immediate right of C. Okay. Why I'm converting? Because already C is in the arrangement, so immediate right of C will be this side because all of them are facing north. So here will be Y. So how many persons are fixed? 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 are fixed. So where is that one more person? So that one more person cannot be between these 36 and Y. It has to be either at the left end or it has to be at the right end. Either at the left end or at the right end. It means how many possibilities do we have? 2 possibilities. So let us draw the 2 possibilities to complete the arrangement quickly. Now, what is the first one? Just a moment. One case I am taking here, 36 second from the left hand, 2 gaps. And C here, Y here. It is a one possibility. And another possibility is 36 is at the left end, 2 gaps C, and C is immediate left of Y. And here one more gap. Okay. Now let's move to the next point. What is given? B has 11 pens less than the person who sits third to the left of C. So what is given regarding B? B has 11 pens less than whom? The one who sits third left of C. B is equal to third left of C minus 11 pins. Number of pins with B is equal to third left of C minus 11. Who is third left of C in both the cases? First left, second left, third left, 36. So B is having how much? 36 minus 11, that is 25. So B is having how many pins? 25 pins. In both the cases, third left of C is 36. So 36 minus 11, 25. So in any case, the number of pins with B is equal to how many? 25. Next. Where can I place pins? I can place in so many places. Next. The sum of the number of pins with B and Z is equal to 68. So what is mentioned? B plus G is equal to 68. And you know B is how much? 25. So 25 plus G is equal to 68. Now G will be equal to how much? 43. But where to place? Again, so many places for these. So let's move to the next point. What is the important point is given? Z sits third to the right of A. Third right is nothing but how many gaps? Two gaps to the right side of A. Who will be there? Z will be there. So A, right side two gaps, and who will be there? G will be there. Now let's check it that where it is possible. A, two gaps, G. That's it, the only possibility. Because already C and Y are fixed. Next, A, two gaps, Z, not possible. A, two gaps, G, not possible. A, two gaps, G is possible. So A here, G here. Right. Now, what is the age of G? I mean, the number of pins with G is 43. The number of pins with G is 43. Right. Now, B has 25 pins. Now, in this arrangement, where can I fix? So, here will be B and here will be 25. Only remaining place for both B and 25. Here, B and 25. Only remaining place. Okay, fine. Next, what is given? The number of pins with A is equal to the square of the number of persons, okay, who sit to the right of X. So number of pins with A is equal to square of what? Number of persons to the right of X, right of X persons. Number of pins with A is equal to number of persons to the right of X persons whole square. Okay, let's check it. Now where can I fix the X? A, B, Z, C, Y, X is will be here. Okay. B, A, C, Y, Z, X will be here. Okay. Now here, in this case, right side of X, how many are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. So, 4 square will be 16. So, A is 16 in this case. Okay, fine. Now here, right side of case 2, right side of X, how many are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 5 square is 25. But already B has 25 pins. We know that each person has a different number of pins. So again to A, we cannot give 25 pins. So this case is completely ruled out. So this case is valid. Now what? So far it is fixed. A 16, X 36, B 25, Z 43, C and Y. Let's see. Next, what is given? The difference between the number of pins with the persons who sits adjacent to C is 7. The number of pins with the person who sits adjacent to C is 7. Adjacent to C is Z and Y. Okay. So adjacent to C is Z and Y. These two persons' difference is 7. Z is 43. Y value can be higher than G or lower than G. If it is higher, it will be 50. If it is lower, it will be 36. But is 36 is already given to X. So it cannot be 36. So Y has to be 50. Y is 50. And last point, one of the persons has 73 pins. Who left? C. So C has 73 pins. Okay. So please note it down. Now answer the question. Who has the highest number of pins? C. 73 pins. Choice 3. Which of the following combinations is definitely true? Y73? No. G16? No. B43? No. A24? No. X36? Yes. 5th option. Choice 5. Next. In a certain way, A is related to Y. In the same way, X is related to C. Let's identify the relation between A and Y and X and C. A, Y. Okay. Number of persons to the left of A is same as number of persons to the right of Y. Okay. Corresponding positions. X and C. Number of persons to the left of X is 1 and number of persons to the right of C is also 1. So corresponding positions. Now what is the question asked? Following the same, who is related to Z? Number of persons to the right of Z is 2. So left of whom is 2? B. Corresponding positions. B. Choice 1. Make a correction. It is choice 1. What is the average of the number of pins with the person who sit to the left of B? Left of B. 16 plus 36, which is nothing but 8 plus 18, 26. Choice 2. 16 plus 36 by 2 is 26. Choice 2. What is the position of the person who has 73 pins with respect to B? So here is the one who has 73 pins and here is B. So from here to here we need to check. From B to here. So first right, second right. Second to the right. Choice 3. With this we have done with the first set. And it is very, very important model. Instead of the values, you may be given a colors or you may be given some fruits, some extra variable. But ultimately, a solving approach will be same. Okay. I hope you are clear with this model. Let's move to the next important model. Years based. 7 persons, P, Q, R, S, T, U and V. Sometimes the number of persons may be given more. 9, 10 like that also. Okay. 7 persons P, Q, R, S, T, U and V were born on the same date of the same month and in a different year among 1978, 1981 and so on, but not necessarily in the same order. The age of each person is calculated as on the same date of the same month, 2020. Okay. So, by reading this information, one point we can understand that we don't know who was born in which year, but definitely we can say that first person must have born in the year 1978, second person must have born in the year 1981 and so on. So what you can understand here, you can freeze the years. You can freeze the years. And also what is the base date is given? 2020. So freeze the years as well as identify the ages. Suppose if the person born in 1978, what will be his age? 2020 minus 1978. Which is equal to 42. 2020 minus 1981, which is equal to 39, and so on. So write the years as well as identify the ages basing on the base date, 2020. Okay, because it is given same date of the same month. Each of them were born on the same date of the same month and calculation is based on the 2020. And be careful with the given year. Okay. Now, we'll copy this information to the next slide. There we'll discuss. So what we can freeze here? We can freeze the years. So here are the years and their ages. Directly it is taken. 2020. Okay. So 42, 39, 34 and so on. What is the first clue is given? S was born in an odd number year. Okay. S was born in odd number year means could be 1981, 1999, 2009. Three possibilities. Okay. Let's move. Just we have done with the one point only. Two persons were born between S and V. Two persons were born between S and V. Okay. If it is S, 1, 2, V. Okay, valid. So this case is valid still. If it is S, 1, 2, V, it is also valid. If it is S, 1, 2, V, it is also valid. So how many possibilities we have? Still we have a three possibilities. So let's check the each and every possibility. Let me take the S here first. S, 1, 2 gap and V. Now what is given? Difference between the ages of V and P is 21 years. V and P is 21 years. Difference between V and P is equal to 21 years. Okay, and we know the wage of V in this case 26. P could be higher value or lower value. If it is the lower side, it should be 20. I mean, it should be 5. It should be 5. I'm sorry, it should be 5. If it is a higher side, it should be 47. It should be 47. But we don't have 47 and we don't have 5. Means S cannot be in the year 2009. So this possibility is ruled out. I hope it is clear. Okay, let me erase this point. So 2009 possibility is ruled out. Now we have the another possibility, S 1981, S 1999. Let's check the S 1981. S 1981, 1, 2 gaps and V. Okay, now the difference between the ages of V and P is 21. V and P is equal to 21. Okay, so V is already 21. Okay, so P could be higher or lower. So if it is a lower, it should be 0, but no person's age is 0. If it is higher, it should be 42. 42, 21 difference is 21. Yes. Yes, there is one person whose age is 42. So perfectly matching. So it is P. So this is perfectly valid. But we have the one other possibility, right? S can be taken here also. So let me take the another possibility. So S is here. 1, 2 gap and V is here. Now, difference between the ages of V and P is equal to 21 years. What is the age of V? 39. So P value could be higher or lower, but higher more than 39, only 42 is there. So no need to go for higher value. So let's go with the lower value. How much could be lower value? 39 minus 21, which is 18. Is there any person's age is 18? Yes. Here there is a one value 18, so I can say it is P. So the age of P is 18, perfectly matching. So both the cases are valid so far. This one is valid. This one is also valid. But we have completed up to this point. Let's move further. The number of persons who were born before P is the same as the number of persons who were born after R was born. Corresponding positions. Before P, 0. So after R, 0. Before P, 5. So after R, 5. But after V is 5. So this case is ruled out. Now only one case is valid. PS, V are fixed. Next. The sum of the ages of T plus U is equal to 52 years. The sum of the ages of T plus U equal to 52 years. So sum of which two values is 52? Now just we left with 34, 26, 18. So 34 plus 18 is 52. But T is 34 or 18, U is 18 or 34, that we don't know. So it is T or U or T. Now the only person who is remaining, Q. So the age of Q is 26 years. But we have not yet done. We have one more point. What is given? Q was not born after U was born. Q was not born after U was born means Q was born before U was born. So with this we can clear this point. So Q is here. So Q was born before U. So it is U. When it is U, T was born in the year 1986. So this is my final arrangement. So P, S, T, Q, V, U, R. So please note it down. So in prelims, they won't give much a higher level of difficulty. They will give simple puzzles only. In mains, they will give you higher level of difficulty, but in prelims, they will give you easy level of difficulty. In reasoning section, you can attempt minimum 25 in 20 minutes of time. Sometimes you can attempt 30 also. And remember that in prelims, reasoning is the only easiest section. Okay? Who was born in 1994? Who was born in 1994? Q. So choice 4. Four of the following five are alike, odd me out. S was born in odd number year. P, even numbered year. Okay, odd number, even number year. T, even number year. Q, even number year. U, even number year. So except O, all were born on even number year. So choice 1. The number of persons who were born between T and U is the same as the number of persons born after. Between T and U, how many are there? 2 people. So the same is true for number of persons who were born after V. So after we have 2 people. So choice 2. Which of the following statements is definitely true? True statement. T is 34 years old. Yes. But there is one of the option, all are true. So we have to go through the remaining. Only 3 persons were born after Q was born. Yes, after Q, 3 persons were born. Now I can choose directly all are true. Because there is no such option more than one of the above. P was born in 1978. Yes. The average of T and Q is 30. T 34, Q 26, 60, average 30. Yes, all are true. Choice 5. In which year was the person who was born immediately after P was born? So P is here. Immediately after P was, S was born, and in the year 1981. Choice 4. Choice 4. Okay, so that's it for today. Practice the puzzles and get back with the doubts. Thank you. Have a great day.